ending it, most people, the intuitive response is to struggle to move, and as soon as you move anything, it's over. If that doesn't work, what people all over the world do, including modern North Americans who had not been told to do it, what they do is pray. And in almost all cases, people told me that as soon as it occurred to them to pray, it went away.
Usually when somebody has this, they'll say, you should go to the monk, and the monk needs to look at your level of paralysis, which is your luck level, or whether you have high bad luck. This is what everybody will say. So the family will often take the person to the temple, or they'll go on their own, and the monk will ask the birth date, and he will, in some cases, they have a wheel, and they'll calculate where you fall on the wheel. There's one of these. On one part of the wheel, there's something called gruach, meaning bad luck cuts off your head. And it means that your state of luck, as they call it, is horrible. That you're, and it usually lasts for a year. Then they'll do something like a water anointing ceremony, where they'll simply make holy water by chanting, sort of sending power into the water, a candle dripping into the water, the sense of transferring sacred energies into the water, and then we'll sprinkle this on your body to increase your force. We'll tie something around your wrist, and we'll chant and call your soul into your body to strengthen you. It may tell you to recite the name of the Buddha as you go to sleep, so you'll be protected.
At night time, before they go to sleep, go into a meditative stage and surround yourself with light. Maybe also apply a coat, a gauze of light, and put it around your body. Or just imagine you're in a bubble of light and you are protected.
There are certainly several different methods people can use to calm the body. What we know is that breathing deeply through the nose and out through the mouth three times. Three seems to be the magic number. Okay, three times seems to reset our internal clock.
Don't take naps in the morning, lying on your back, especially if you're REM deprived. But naps in the morning, naps seem to make it more likely than ordinary sleep. Sleeping in the morning, I'm talking about like 8, 9, 10 o'clock, seems to make it more likely.
In my opinion, these attacks can be stopped or thwarted by them, their faith, okay, seeking faith, surrounding themselves in whatever, okay, creates a safe space for them, sacred space, contacting and connecting with their angelic forces. Angels were given to us to use. We truly need, and I don't mean to sound preachy about angels, but truly, utilize your angels. They're there. Utilize them.
Don't sleep on your back. It's not a good idea to sleep on your back anyway, orthopedically. And somewhere around 70-75% of, in my data, all sleep paralysis attacks happen when you're lying on your back.
What I usually do also is I've learned to sleep on my side, on the right side or the left side, but I don't sleep on my back and I don't sleep on my stomach any longer.
If you've never talked to anybody about this, you should. You'll have more friends, a closeness with them is what I mean, more of a closeness with all these people that you didn't know was there, if you can just find the right person to talk to about your inner self and let them know. It could be your closest friend you don't even know.
So get enough sleep. If you wake up from sleep paralysis during the night, don't go right back to sleep. Because if you do, it's very likely to happen immediately again. Get up, just walk around a bit, have a glass of water, then go back to sleep. That makes it less likely to recur.
If you find that you're experiencing something that's disturbing, it's incredibly important to look for help and to talk about it. And you won't get locked up and you won't get put on meds. And in fact, you may become leaders in this new evolution of human psyche, this transpersonal experience that many of us feel and experience but have not yet been able to put into words.
I can't believe I'm not alone.